everyone, I'm going to show you how to get professional quality box braids or poetic justice braids, whatever you call them. I'm going to show you the tools that you need. And first, I want to suggest everyone to get a rat tail comb because it's great for sectioning the hair off, and you can do any types of sections that you want. This is one tip. The parting for box braids, it's crucial to look professional. So you can take them any way you want, part them down in diamonds or squares, but make them look cute and neat. That's one thing. And then the hair. And I'm going to use this hair just for instructional use purposes. This pink hair, I wouldn't really wear it in my hair, but I have used it on clients, so that's why I have it left over. But you want to get it, you want to separate it and prepare it so that the ends are not even. And this can take quite some time, but you want to get it nice and uneven. You see the ends there, uneven, because this helps. This is another professional tip. When you braid the hair down, it goes from fat to skinny, and you don't have like a even edge, and it looks corny basically. You want that uneven edge so you can braid all the way down so you can get it fat to skinny. And that's what I'm doing here. And then I'm going to take it. Well, first, this is another tip. You have to moisturize the hair, because when you put a protective style in, I don't care what it is, box braids or crochet braids, you have to moisturize your hair so when you take those braids out, that your hair won't come out with it. You have to moisturize so to give your hair time to grow and stay, you know, stay nice and fresh. So I'm going to just part it in half, and I'm just going to grip my hair. Yes, I'm going to grip it, and then I'm going to just loop the synthetic hair, the kinkalon hair, around my hair. And then another tip is that you have to borrow some hair from the synthetic hair and mix it all together, and you want every strand to be even and equal. So there's no big ones or small ones. You want it to lay flat and make it look nice, and you're going to braid it all the way down. And then next, I'm going to show you a next section, but it's going to be with the black hair. And another thing that professionals do, they section the hair close together. I'm not going to do that right now because my edges, it can't take it. So I like to preserve my edges, but they part it close together to give it that nice full look. But like I said, I'm not going to do that right now, and I'm just going to do the same thing I did with that pink hair. And I did the pink so you can see how what my hair is doing. So I am conditioning my hair, and then I'm taking that black hair, and then I'm combing through. I'm sorry, I'm detangling. That's the one thing you need to do, is detangle your hair for the perfect result. And then I'm taking that black hair, and I'm just showing you how to loop the hair. Loop it, and then right here I'm going to take it and twist my hair, well, the synthetic hair, twist it. There I go. And then I'm adding my hair with the synthetic hair. And as I go down, you can see that I'm borrowing hair from each strand just to keep it even all the way down. And I did it one more time to show you guys what. But remember, so you want to part the hair nicely. You want to part the hair into equal sections, and the ratio of the hair has to be equal to the hair, the synthetic hair. And pretty much that's it with the braiding. I'm going to show you guys again. Detangle, condition, and then you braid it all the way down. And another tip is make sure the hair as you braid it, it's starting from the middle. You don't want it too far to the left or too far to the right or all the way down or up. Make sure it's directly in the middle. And I feel like this loop method that I do, braiding it in half, it helps with no knots at the top. You don't see any knots at the top of my head, and that's what I like, because knots cause breakage. Well, now that I'm done braiding, you can see as I braid all the way down, those little straggles, those things make the hair look old and ugly, basically. So I'm going to take my scissors and I'm just going to take my scissors and clip off everyone that I see. And this can take some time. Sometimes when I braid, I do a row by row. And I think that's better than waiting till the end, because you can really stop and take your time to do it. And if you braid your hair all over and then you try to do it, it's just too much. So do it row by row. That's what I suggest. And as you can see, I did them and they look better. So I'm going to take some wrapping foam lotion just to add more shine, because when professionals do your hair, it comes out nice and shiny. And I'm going to take it all the way down, and it gives it a firm hold. And then I take my old measuring cup, I put some boiling hot water in there, an old towel, and I dip the ends in for about 20 seconds. I dip it in for 20 seconds and then you're done. If you don't like the edge, you could clip on, but that's about it, guys. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and please remember to watch me in HD. I love you guys. Subscribe, subscribe, and subscribe.